6 years after the conflict in eastern Ukraine began, over 1.2 million pensioners are living in regions controlled by Russia-backed armed groups. They can collect their pensions only by crossing into government-held territory. Before COVID-19, there are more than a million crossings each month. Many could make the journey in one day to access banking and other services, which are just a few hundred meters from Ukrainian government checkpoints. COVID-19 restrictions have changed this, as both sides require those crossing to self-isolate. This means finding accommodation for 14 days, something most pensioners cannot afford. As a result, most people haven't been able to collect their pensions at all since March, and many pensioners are being pushed into poverty. Many have cut back on food, others can't afford vital medications or hygiene products. Some who have few other options still try crossing.
Я приехал сюда на Украину получить пенсию свою. Вот еще я не получил пенсию, а во мне уже 50 или 60 килограмм. Вот я уже еле разговариваю. Я через 3-4 дня тоже попаду в обморок.
The Ukrainian government said it would lift self-isolation requirements on August 1st, but restrictions remained in place in September. It is 6 months since restrictions came into effect and older people lost access to their pensions. With winter approaching, their situation becomes more dire each day. The Ukrainian government should introduce ways to ensure they can collect their pensions during the pandemic. The Russia-backed armed groups should also lift arbitrary restrictions.